Hi everyone, my name is Siana Fisher and I have the portrait of Marie Antoinette with a rose by Elizabeth Vigée Lebrun as my artwork presentation. And I chose this artwork because I find the story of Marie Antoinette very fascinating, how this high, very beautiful and wealthy aristocrat betrays the country she's ruling over and is executed for it. I wanted to dive deeper into the research of the queen as a person, as well as study the style that the artist, Elizabeth Lebrun, was painting, which was the Rococo style period. I enjoy that style of art a lot. I think the pastels that are used in the types of painting during that time period is very beautiful and elegant. And so, yeah, so some observational facts that I researched and studied while doing this project. The subject is a portrait of Marie Antoinette, who was the Queen of France during the French Revolution. So that's kind of like the political thing that was going on during that time, was the French Revolution. In the background, there's also a landscape, and that can be noted as another subject, but the main subject is portrait. The style is generally considered part of the Rococo period in 1783, with elements of a neoclassical style. That's really how Lebrun painted majority of the time, and majority of her paintings was neoclassical style and Rococo. The Rococo period represents any art, sculpture, architecture that combines asymmetry, scrolling curves, gilding, white and pastel colors, sculpted molding, and trompe l'oeil, which is fool the eye. And we learned that earlier this semester. They do this in order to create surprise and the illusion of motion and drama. But I'll touch on all of that in the next slide, where I show another example of a painting from like the same period. The medium used in this painting is oil on canvas, and the dimensions are 51 inches by 34 inches. So about like 4 feet by 3 feet to give you like perspective on the size. And then the function is portrait. Marie Antoinette loved getting her portrait painted, and I have some more facts on that whenever I go over the artist herself. The cabbage rose that you see Marie holding was a signature flower for her, because in the portrait, it's at the peak of its bloom, which can kind of represent how Marie viewed herself while being the Queen of France, because after all, she was married to Louis XVI at the age of 14. So back then, that was like the prime time for marriage and babies, hence the term like peak of its bloom. The rose also represents her Christian faith, as well as a nod to her Austrian heritage. Marie was a large spender of the royal family, especially on like clothes and jewelry. She was very extravagant. She loved to party. And she spent a bunch of money during her time ruling over as the Queen of France. So like the crisp satin and delicate lace of her dress that you see in the painting kind of helps depict her wealth and royal position, as well as like the color scheme. There's a lot of monochromatic blues and grays, and then lots of pastels used, which is another attribute to the Rococo period. The blue tones used in this artwork kind of show royalty, as that is what we kind of associate blue with, is royalty. So the darker tones of like black and gray kind of give the painting a greater emphasis on the color that there is, which is like the brightness of her skin or the brightness of her dress, and the brightness of like the flowers, the pastels in the flower. The darker tones kind of bring out that brightness a little bit more, I feel. And then in the compare and contrast, I chose an artwork that kind of has the same style as Elizabeth Lebrun's paintings during the Rococo period. It's in the same period. It's called, and it's also known as, The Swing, but the original title was The Happy Accidents of the Swing, and it's painted by Jean-Henri Fragonard in 1767. Like the one painted by Lebrun, is an oil on canvas, and it has a similar pastel colors, such as the pinks and the daunting blue and green landscape in the background, but this one kind of has like a little bit more green, which it can also serve as a subject, like I said in the previous slide, but both of them are kind of more like portrait. This painting is kind of promiscuous. Whenever you like really look at it, when you first look at it, you're just like, oh, it's a girl on a swing, like in the woods, whatever. But it actually has like a very promiscuous hidden meaning whenever you like kind of look closer at the painting. So it kind of depicts an elegant young woman like on a swing. And then in the left-hand corner, there's a man laying at like the perfect vantage point to see up her dress as she swings forth and the wind blows through her dress. And this is kind of the time when they didn't wear underwear. So you can kind of guess like just how promiscuous this painting is. And then at the right-hand corner, you in the dark shadows, you see a man who's like propelling the swing. And then there's a few other things like the statues of like the angels kind of in shock and the little angel going like this as like a sound of silence. This style of like frivolous painting kind of became the target of philosophers of the Enlightenment because they demanded a more serious art that would show like the nobility of man rather than the like promiscuity of man. And contrastingly, this portrait shows time in motion, hence like the swing. It kind of shows like motion more than time, but definitely motion, especially if you look right by her foot, she has kicked up her shoe. So that kind of shows motion as well, while Marie Antoinette's portrait doesn't really show much motion. So yeah. And then the artist herself, Elizabeth Louise Vigée Lebrun, that's her whole name, was born on April 16, 1755 in Paris to a father who was a successful artist, and he encouraged her interest in art. She took lessons from Gabriel Briard, and at the age of 17, she began to attract wealthy clients who wanted their portraits painted. At 23, she received first state commission to paint Marie Antoinette for the Queen's mother, Empress Maria Theresa of Austria in 1778. And the Queen and her mother liked the way that Lebrun depicted Antoinette so much that they formed a lasting relationship with her, which resulted in Lebrun painting Marie Antoinette's portrait about 30 times, including with her kids and everything. Marie Antoinette was a huge patron for Lebrun as her career blossomed. Lebrun also enjoyed doing lots of self-portraits of herself, sometimes accompanied by her daughter. She only had one child and it was a daughter. Lebrun sensed the coming of the revolution would overthrow the royal family and aristocracy, so she left France with her daughter and fled to Italy. In 1792, her name was added to the official list of émigrés. I'm probably pronouncing that wrong, but it's a person who has left their home country or the country that they take residence in due to political or social exile. And because of that, her property was seized by the state and she was actually declared legally dead, even though she was alive and well living with her daughter in Italy. In 1800, her name was removed and she returned to her home in France, where she died 42 years later on March 30th, 1842. So then a little bit about the aristocrat herself, Marie Antoinette, the main focus of the portrait. Marie Antoinette was born on November 2nd, 1755, and died on October 16th, 1793 by the guillotine, which is kind of one of the most famous deaths by guillotine, I think. Whenever I think of guillotine, I immediately think of Marie Antoinette. The French Revolutionary Tribunal found her guilty of aiding the enemy and adding fuel to the fire during the French Civil War. She kind of stabbed her country in the back and went behind everybody's backs and betrayed everyone, helping her home country of Austria. So The French citizens despised her as she was way too extravagant with her lifestyle, with like the spending and the way she kind of portrayed and held herself. She did include, though, like many charitable contributions to the poor population of France, which makes her infamous saying, "Let them eat cake," seem kind of out of character. But she actually never said that. Lots of people, whenever they hear Marie Antoinette, that's the first thing that they think of is, oh, let them eat cake. That's the lady who said, let them eat cake. But she actually never said that. On her way to the guillotine, a lot of people think that's what she said. But her actual last words were, sorry, mister, I didn't mean to put that there. And she was talking about her foot. She stepped on the executioner's foot before she was killed. And that those were actually her last words. But the let them eat cake sentence was said by Maria Theresa of Spain, who actually lived about 100 years before Antoinette and was married to Louis XIV. So I think that's kind of like where the confusion happens. So that is it for my presentation. I hope you all enjoyed, and see you next time.